Hello and welcome everybody, it's JWitz here with another Pokemon TCG Online video. Today we have a very interesting deck. This thing is being talked about a lot in the Pokemon trading card game community because of how weird it is and how it's still somehow seeing some tournament success, and that is the Power of One. You might remember that subtitle from Pokemon the Movie 2000, the second major Pokemon movie, and would you look at that? You have the three legendary birds that were in that movie, Zapdos, Moltres, Articuno, and even Big Bird Lugia EX himself. Now that is interesting. Now, at face value, this almost looks like a joke deck. Like, yes, you did get these Pokemon that were from the movie and put them all in one deck. However, most of these, especially these legendary birds, the Articuno, Zapdos, and Moltres, they've seen very, very little amounts of tournament play. Why get this group together right now? And the answer is that this deck seems to perform really well because of type advantages. Donphan's popular in the format. Articuno can attack for water, one-shot Donphan's. It's also resistant to fighting, which is good. Zapdos is great against popular Yveltal and Yveltal EX, weak to lightning. Moltres is great against Virizion Genesect, their grass, weak to fire. So while these attacks don't seem that great at first, they have the benefit of the full Plasma deck engine, and also the times 2 weakness on a lot of popular decks. So that sort of seems to be the gimmick. Now, does it still work? Not 100% sure, but it is starting to see some tournament results. I've seen on the Verbank City, it's a forum on Facebook, it's all about the Pokemon trading card game. I'm not a humongous fan of Verbank City, actually, to be honest. Sometimes the community can be a little toxic, much like the actual Verbank City itself. There's a lot of elitist players that sometimes aren't so nice to newer players. I'm not saying go there to have a good time, but if you do want information on the Pokemon trading card game, oftentimes information passes all over this group. One of the big things that was dropped was this deck. I believe the creator goes by the name of Peter Kicka. It could be Kissa as well. It's K-I-C-A, probably Kicka. But he dropped this list online, and then we saw really big players like Dylan Bryan post some results for this deck, saying that they used Peter's list as a sort of base. So I've done the same. I've used Peter's list as a base. You can find the original deck list in the description below. I'll link you guys to that Verbank post. But otherwise, this is pretty close to the original Peter list. And it is just so weird. Again, these Pokemon, they might have good type advantages, but hey, you really don't use them that often in competitive play. So you do have the standard Plasma engine. It's Deoxys EX and Power Connect. For each Deoxys EX that you have in play, all your Team Plasma Pokemon, all these blue bordered cards are all Team Plasma. Your entire Pokemon lineup is Plasma. They get an extra 10 damage per Deoxys. Typically your goal is to get 3, maybe even 4 in a play, so you're dealing a constant extra 30 or 40 damage. And you can boost that with Muscle Band as well, so you can get up to like 50, 60 extra damage on some of these attacks, making them a lot more impressive. A 2 for 30 attack can all of a sudden become 2 for like 80, 90, and that can be a lot. That can pile up for a 2-shot on an EX Pokemon sometimes. Culverus Machine still allows you to attach a Plasma Energy card straight from your deck to one of your Team Plasma Pokemon. That's a free energy, a second energy attachment, doesn't count as one you do from your hand. That's huge. You've also got some interesting tools like Frozen City. Whenever a player attaches an energy to one of their Pokemon that is not Team Plasma, they get 2 damage counters. Right now, stadiums are becoming bigger and bigger in the Pokemon trading card game, which I personally love, and so you do want to run a counter stadium. This one's pretty nice. Your opponent might just take 2 damage counters because they don't run Plasma Pokemon, and because your deck is entirely Plasma, you will never take any damage from it, which is nice. You also have Team Plasma Ball. It simply searches your deck for a Team Plasma Pokemon and puts it in your hand. This is probably the best search trainer in the game when used in a Plasma deck, because you don't even have to deal any extra requirements like Ultra Ball discarding 2 energy. Just search for a Plasma, get them in play, and what do you know? Again, all Plasma. So overall, it looks like the Plasma decks of old, but you're using all of these interesting attackers that you just don't see ever. I'm still a little skeptical on this one. While some of these Pokemon do have interesting finishing moves, if you look at Zapdos and Moltres especially, Power Flame, and I think it's Power Volt, They deal 120 damage if you have a plasma energy attached. So if you're able to accelerate a few plasmas with the Kolosh machine or something, that's 120. Let's say you have three more Deoxys EX in play, that's 150. Muscle Band, all of a sudden that's 170. That's knocking out most other Pokemon EXs right then and there. That's a good finishing move, but again, you still need to get the four energy attached, and you can't even cheat with double colorless because one of them has to be a plasma. You have light acceleration with the Thunderous EX and Raiden Knuckle to attach some energy to your discard pile, but he's fighting weak, which makes him really a lot weaker in this format with all the Stonphan, so you're not going to use him every game. And so my question I'm trying to figure out is, can you get by with some of these weaker 2 energy attacks, maybe by piling up extra damage with some of these extra Deoxys, and can this still be competitive? Is typing alone enough to win some games? We're going to figure that out. You also have Lugia EX to close games. However, I'm not even 100% sure if this is a great card in here. Plasma Gale is great for knocking out a Pokemon and getting an extra prize card, but it is a 4 energy attack. You're not abusing double colorless. This list only runs one double colorless, so it's not often you're going to get all 4 energy on Lugia. I'm almost questioning if he's in here just because it fits the movie. I don't know. Sometimes the Pokemon trading card game is about having fun. If you want to build a deck around one of the most popular Pokemon movies and have a little fun with it, maybe even be competitive at a tournament, then all the power to you. We're going to try and have some fun with this deck right now. Let's see if we can get some wins using the power of one in a real tournament setting. It appears we've won the coin flip. You can choose if you want to go first or second. This is a bit of a slower deck, so you always want to go first. Try and get as much setup as you can, and start attacking on turn two if possible with one of your birds. So this is not the ideal opponent we're facing. We have a Manectric EX we're staring off. Can deal some decent damage. Zapdos EX is actually lightning weak. It's lightning Pokemon, but it's taking the flying type thing from the video games here. Decided to drop my Frozen City Stadium card, which is great. Adds 2 damage counters every time your opponent attaches an energy. Well, at any time either player attaches an energy from their hand onto a non-team plasma Pokemon. But I say your opponent because that does not affect me. I run only Team Plasma Pokemon. All these cards with the blue border around them are Team Plasma. This archetype has been around for a long time, and it really always has a chance in the format, it seems. There's just a lot of support cards. Like the Team Plasma Ball that you saw me drop just searches through my entire deck, and I can just grab Team Plasma Pokemon. Don't have to discard out of my hand. No other requirements. Just get the Pokemon that you need for your deck. It's pretty nice. Plasma has seen a couple of things that hurt it, though. Normally you run more Thunderous for the setup, but it's fighting weak. There's so much Donphan. But hey, these birds are all resistant to fighting. It sort of helps. I don't know. This is a super weird deck still. I don't know if this is a major archetype or not. A lot of people have been reporting that it's been cropping up more at tournaments, but it's hard to know what to trust and what to not. My opponent drops the Malmar EX in the bench. It's Maximar attack. Can deal a ton of damage with a lot of energy acceleration. So if they get like a Mega Manectric out, they can really start wreaking havoc. And it also has a neat ability where every time you attach to it, you automatically put your opponent's Pokemon to sleep. That puts them at a 50-50 shot on a coin flip for whether they'll wake up, and that hurts. So Manectric did take 2 damage counters from that Frozen City, which is nice, but they replaced it, which is not. Also with Shadow Circle, which gives any Pokemon with a Darkness Energy attached to them no weakness. So that Assault Laser's looking pretty deadly. Will definitely knock me out next turn if my opponent has a Rainbow or Lightning. I'm not 100% sure how this build functions. I've seen a few lists and they all operate a little differently. But one thing dawns on me that could possibly keep me alive to the next turn. Depends on if they get a Muscle Band or not. This Rainbow Energy, actually, it doesn't matter because the Rainbow Energy does the extra 10 damage. We'll still get knocked out. But it is an interesting little thing. When you attach the Rainbow Energy to Zapdos EX, it gives you no weakness. It counts as a darkness. It's a really ugly hand. 3 Juniper. You never want to discard your other Junipers. You want to sort of spread them out. It's just such a powerful draw card. And we just lost almost all of them in the entire deck. so I can set a few more birds down. And we're gonna leave this to fate. I have agility, flip a coin if heads, prevent all effects of attacks and damage to Zapdos next turn. Being able to prevent all that damage, just being able to survive no matter what, that would be great. I figure I'm already starting off pretty slow as is. Let's risk it for the flip. And we whiff. Ugh, heartbreaker. So now, if my opponent has that lightning energy, they can knock me out. Oh, just kidding, they don't have it. Instead, they've attached to the Malamar and have put me to sleep. I am definitely okay with this. So they could have knocked me out with that assault laser attack because it deals extra damage when you have a Pokemon tool attached to you. Would have knocked me out perfectly, even though I am preventing weakness. However, since all they can do is overrun, I do get to prevent some of that weakness damage on Zapdos. Yay. So I'm checking my discard. Ugh, the three Juniper. So gross. And we got a lot of supporters in hand. One really great supporter right now is that Colress. Allows me to shuffle my hand into my deck. Draw a card for each bench Pokemon in play, mine and my opponent's. We have got 9 in play right now. Shuffle draw 9 is huge, absolutely huge. It's a strong card in Plasma decks especially, because you run the Plasma Ball, and you usually have 3, sometimes even 4 Deoxys EX in play. Boom! So I decided to attach that energy, just in case I didn't hit one. Maybe could have held off in case I could get a real easy like switch into the Thunderous EX, accelerate some energy, and knock out the Manectric. Unfortunately, it didn't work out perfectly, but we do still have in here an out to switch, which allows me to escape the sleep. I flip tails between turns, which is kind of terrible. But we can get around this. So I've got Computer Search, trying to debate which two cards I want to discard. I do kind of like Lysander the discard, because you can Versus Secret back later. And yeah, I know, I'm running out of time. I decided to drop the N. I could have dropped the last Juniper in the deck. Decided maybe I should hold on to this. It's the strongest draw. We've got other N's, we do not have other Junipers. So I've got myself that switch. Just allows you to switch. It's been in, I think, every single format, something like that. Just one of those Pokemon cards that never dies. In fact, in the next set, there's actually going to be a golden, I think it's golden switch. That sounds right. Which is going to be awesome. So I can replace my opponent's stadium. That gives me access to some of these dark Pokemon's lightning weakness, which could be helpful. So my lightning Pokemon. Also, every time they attach, they're going to have to rack on that extra damage. So I decide to switch to the Articuno. Only has one retreat cost, so switch, retreat. Ta-da! We're ready to go. And agility will knock out. Despite it only being a 2 energy for 30 attack, that adds up when you have all these Deoxys EX in play and a Muscle Band. In fact, the Deoxys deal just as much damage as the attack on their own. That ability just allows you to deal 10 extra damage for all your plasma. Ah! Stadium is replaced. Okay, this is bad. I only run 2 of the Frozen City. Now that they're gone, chances are very, very slim. Unless I hit something like the Lysander Trump card. We're not going to see those again. We're out of counter stadiums. So even though this Eviltal looks so easy to knock out with the lightning weakness across from me, I can no longer take advantage of weakness. It's a huge bummer. Checking up on the discard pile. We have already run through all 14 Plasma Ball. Have not really touched many of the Colress Machine or Colress Energy, which is good. That's acceleration that can really hit you at just about any time. And now it's time to think. I don't want this Zapdos EX to get knocked out, if possible. And what's nice is these birds only have one retreat cost. Oftentimes, EX Pokemon like this have 2, like the Deoxys. So I can retreat pretty easily and even just replace that one energy by attacking with Rhydonuckle on Thundurus. Got the lightning energy now in hand, and that's the strategy we're going to go with. It is a huge bummer that Shadow Circle card is becoming more and more valuable in dark decks. Being able to prevent weakness is big. Otherwise, I'd be getting a knockout with Thundurus EX. That times 2 multiplier is really huge. However, we can still deal a lot of damage here. I'm trying to debate if I want to discard the Rainbow or the Plasma. We can re-accelerate anything. Rhydonuckle allows you to search your discard pile. Attach an energy from your discard to one of your Pokemon. We have the Muscle Band too, so this could actually be a two-hit knockout now. We're dealing 80 instead of 60, and that is the magic number where we can knock out this Eviltal Small in two hits. So I decide, okay, let's just re-accelerate that Plasma Energy. And I'm going to go ahead and diversify here. I figure I'm getting the knockout. Let's just keep attacking with Thunderous EX, accelerate as much as we can, get this board ready where we have two birds ready to go. My opponent doesn't seem to be threatening any kind of immediate knockouts yet. That Malamar could get a little ugly if they can accelerate to it a little bit more. But we were able to deal with the Manectric. Ooh, that's interesting. They were able to drop a Max Potion. Removes all the damage on Eviltal, but did lose its energy, which they just reattached. Okay. There's Lysander's trump card. It's a very, very cool full art. You don't really... I don't know. It's an interesting card. Very interesting in the late game. I could use it and get Frozen Cities back into the deck, but just doesn't seem like that's a good enough use for it at the moment. On the bright side, we're not really taking that much damage. Eviltal's dealing 30 at a time. Its attack is actually extremely similar to my Rhydonupple. The difference is I'm dealing a ton more because I've got the Deoxys backing me up alongside the Muscle Man. So debating playing that Versus Seeker. Colrus seems like the play here. Once again, it's a Colrus for 9. That's just so many drawn cards. I need to make sure I can keep getting energy. Boom, here's some energy. So I have kind of a weird situation here. I could load up on the Zapdos and have it ready to go next turn, but if I overcommit all of my energy at once, then if they have a Lysander, they can just pull it up, knock it out, and I sort of have to re-accelerate. So the idea is, while this Thunderous EX is still in no immediate threat of knockout, I can just keep building. Rhydonuckle is a really strong attack. Just grabs in energy. Thunderous has gotten a bit weaker because there's all that fighting Donphan against him. But hey, my opponent does not seem to be running Donphan right now. I'm cool. So here, we've got two energy apiece on both the Zapdos EX and the Articuno. I really debated maybe attaching to the Articuno, that way I could attack next turn, try and paralyze my opponent and lock him up into a knockout. But I think I'm okay with this. By spreading the energy, put myself in a position where if they knock something out, the other thing could still strike, especially if I can find some of those Colrus Machine. That's a big card I've really been hoping to find. Still no luck. On the bright side, even though we did get the Malamar treatment, we were able to wake up on the sleep. That Maximar attack is going to deal a lot. Right now they have 4 energy attached. You flip a coin for each energy attached, and it deals 60 times the amount of heads. With 4 energy, that is going to be, on average, 120 plus the Muscle Band. So if they have one more energy, all they need are just average flips to knock out EXs. So I'm debating on the attachments, decide to just put it on Articuno, get both of my attackers ready. Thunderous EX will probably fall now, but hey, if I attack with it again, it's a whole lot of energy to love. And I hate to have to end, but nothing else in my hand really looked that strong. So we go ahead and shuffle out. Maybe could have played that Megaphone to discard the Pokemon Tool and the Malamar, but not the end of the world. So another Rhydonuckle. It actually does still deal 80 damage a pop. It would have been so sweet to deal 160 for weakness, but that Shadow Circle is so powerful, and it's locked on the board. Also, ending in a 4 energy, maybe not that good. I do need an energy to attack next turn, but still a little disappointing. Glaceon, that's interesting. I know it deals a lot of damage to an EX. Yep, if they're an EX, does 50 more damage. It can be played as sort of a Pyroar counter, I suppose. You need an evolution to hit their Pyroar running an all basic deck. Have not seen that too often, though. My opponent drops a Rainbow Energy on the bench. And on the bright side here, if they do decide to go through this attack, knocking out my Thunderous, I can attack back for the knockout on my end. They're thinking about it. Go ahead and play Skyla. 4 and N. So, that's something my opponent has sort of telegraphed to me. Well, if you decide to knock me out, I'm going to end you, and you're only going to get to draw two cards off it. I'm okay with that, this position. I know I've discarded a lot of supporters, but I've got a lot of energy in play. I can attack on two fronts here, and I'm cool with that. So the Yveltal EX has 90 HP left. Do the math. If I attach once to this Articuno, I can go ahead and Blizzard for 60 plus 30 from the 3 Deoxys EX. Perfect knockout. And that's a lot of HP for the Articuno, 170. Maybe I'll survive this Malamar. We go ahead and Blizzard, it's 90, and hey, 10 each my opponent's bench Pokemon. Sometimes that can help be the magic number for knockouts when you're trying to knock out some of these legendary bird attacks. We're in a pretty decent position. I know they're going to end me to 2, which stinks. We're going to have to get some lucky draws, but if that Malamar stays active, all I need is a Plasma Energy on the Zapdos EX for the knockout. Putting me asleep, but more importantly, it seems they are going all in here on that Maximar attack. End to 2, and oh my goodness, we got the Plasma Energy. That is pretty lucky, not going to lie. So here we go, flip, 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 flip. Oh no, wait, 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 please knock me out. I have the game if you knock me out. We got it. I could have possibly, if they didn't knock me out, I could have flipped heads on sleep, then retreated. But if not, and I stayed asleep, that could have been bad. So yeah, I can't believe it. But yes, Zapdos' second attack deals 120 damage if you have a Plasma Energy attached. So we can deal 120, plus 30 more from the 3 Deoxys, plus 20 from the Muscle Band. That's 170 damage. What is this? Okay, pretty lucky to grab the Plasma Energy off just two cards, but you know what? We'll take it. This deck is kind of weird. I don't know. It's a little slow for my tastes. It's interesting that it has some of these type advantages. I definitely don't think it's a joke deck. It can win games. I've won a few. I just don't think it's necessarily as good as everybody's hyping, but who knows? Regardless, that is the Power of One deck. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. There are more things other than TCG content coming up. I know this isn't like the number one best viewing thing on my channel. Do not worry, there's a fact of the day right around the corner. But until then, I hope you guys are all enjoying the holidays. Have a great time with your friends and family. Stay safe in the winter if it's snowing for you. It's not for me, which is extremely weird. I can't think of the last December I've had in Illinois with no snow. But that's beyond the point. As always, you can click the subscribe button to subscribe to my channel and get alerts when each of my new videos are coming out. And you can check the annotation right above it in order to link back to the last Pokemon TCG video. I'll see you guys soon with some more Pokemon content, some more Nintendo content, and hopefully each Tuesday, a TCG Tuesday video. Have a great day!